help soon. We're coming to the main road. Chris, try to hold on. The burn, we'll get it fixed. Chris, watch it! Chris! Chris! Don't kill him!
Are you playing at? Are you trying to commit suicide or something?
He was delirious. I couldn't hold the cover. Is he all right?
Oh, probably just stunned. What happened to his face?
That's what made him delirious. He was burned.
When did this happen?
About an hour ago. He's been driving ever since.
But I have that looked at. I've never seen a burn like that.
I'll show these to the doctor.
Are these what burned him?
Yes. We were on our way to Windsor Flats for a picnic. There used to be a little village there last year, but the government must have pulled it down or something. We stopped to turn round, and we heard a noise like falling, and Chris had a look. And when I found him, he was like this.
These are nothing but pieces of stone. They couldn't burn anybody.
But him, mister. Chris, darling.
Let's get this back on the road. Take the wheel, will you? Come on, push. Probably suffering from shock.
How he was in the car.
Better get you two into my car.
No, I can manage. Just take him and help him into the car.
Meteorites give a strong trace as soon as they strike the atmosphere. These are different.
What are they?
Whatever they are, they're coming in low and slow. You still holding yours?
Uh-huh. As soon as one lot fades, there are more.
Traces are getting fainter. Yours too?
Yes, mine have gone. What do you make of it?
A sudden fade out. Two possibilities. One, the scanner up there.
Do you think that's likely?
We've modified and reset it so much in the last few days, it's probably a bit liverish. Spots before the eye, so to speak.
And the other?
Those things were real. We lost them because they'd reached the ground.
How far do you make it?
90 to 100 miles north of here. Somewhere in that area, land or sea.
That's pretty rough country, then. Hill, moorland, marsh.
We'll reset the scanner 2 degrees lower and then make a complete circuit.
Check.
Set that scanner. What's it doing at that low level?
Well, we were making some tests, sir.
This observatory, like everything else on this base, was built for one test only. I'll not see it used for any other purpose.
We happen to pick up some rather curious evidence.
I'm not interested in Echo's brand. Neither am I interested in a skilled man like Marsh spending half the night on one of your pet projects.
That's quite unfair.
I wanted to stay, sir.
You had no right to. In the morning, you may be half awake.
Have I ever let you down on a job before?
Tomorrow, you may not have a job. In fact, none of us may have jobs. If you want to do something useful, have these stones classified and entered. They may be meteorites.
Yes, sir. I take it you had a difficult day in London.
I'm sorry. I had no right to jump on you like that.
What happened to the ministry?
Moon project. May it rest in peace.
What?
They're giving us no more money.
No more money? But didn't you explain?
Try and justify this to a committee of Whitehall bureaucrats? Steel domes where men can live in artificial atmosphere, beings alive in a totally dead world? 50 rockets to take the components up there. Solar mirrors, producer units, pressure domes. I didn't go that far, Bran. I just stuck the current cost. You know what they said? To date, you've spent a lot of money on a rocket that isn't even safe to launch. At the moment, we have projects of far more importance. Importance. Friend, isn't it important enough to be the first to build a colony on the moon and to get men there against all odds? These are for tomorrow. I'm going back to school again in the morning.
School?
That's what they told me, Bran. Go back and study atomic theory again. Find out where I went wrong without spending money.
What did you say?
I felt like saying find yourself another director for your rocket group. I quit. If I'd had any pride, that's exactly what I would have
done. They must know we'll get it right. We only need a few months to design and assemble a new reactor, order a new coolant.
Have the girl get this off first thing. Tell him I'm coming over.
The atomic center?
Yes. Telling the gentleman of Harwell that I'm coming back to school. Tomorrow.
This is ludicrous.
Nevertheless, I'm going to do it. I'll play the game their way. For the time being. Anything to keep this together. Can you still bear to look at it? The sum total of our achievement up to now. One rocket. Crewless. Untried.
Because we daren't try it.
We're not sure of that, Dan.
Not sure of that. That nuclear motor is as faulty as...
We're not sure of that.
Listen, Quatermass. Give them that story, but don't try it on me. We know that as soon as that thing left the Earth, we'd be stoking up an atomic bomb.
We could send it up without a crew, by remote control.
If you did, you'd never dare bring it back to Earth.
I intend to correct that fault. I'm going to send it up there and bring it back, not once, but 100 times. You better go get some sleep. I'm going down to the rocket base.
Has the old man checked in yet?
Checked in. Apparently he's been at the launching base all night.
No, well, I want to see him urgently the moment he gets back. Oh, sir, could you come along to the observatory?
Did you get through to Harwell?
Yes. Turn up, Freddy, all right?
Like some coffee.
Done it, Wayne.
Sir, it's about that meteorite.
What about it?
Boy, it fell down. It's got a definite shape, sir.
Where did you get this, Quatermass?
Supposed to have fallen about 90 miles away from here. Why?
It's a new one on me, sir. We don't have this substance classified at all.
Furthermore, it's symmetric.
And hollow.
Probably some pieces missing.
No, sir. The inside's symmetric, too. When did this fall?
Last night. I had a near accident. A couple of kids, they said they picked it up.
Those traces we had on the screen last night.
Yes, that's right. They were about 90 miles away.
You plotted them?
They didn't give the same signals as meteorites.
That's just only an estimate, sir, but that's the rough area.
They came in low and slow, then we lost them, probably because they hit the ground.
Wintered in flats.
What's that?
Girl said wintered in flats.
What girl?
Marsh, get the car.
Well, don't you think you want to have some sleep, sir?
Get the car.
I don't want to seem dense, sir, but I don't understand.
I don't understand either, Brian. That's why I want to have a look at wintered in flats. I want you to make me a reconstruction of the shape of this thing before it hit the atmosphere of the Earth.
Yes, sir.
You can't find it on the map, look in the AAA book.
No, here it is. Winnerton Flats.
Okay. Give me the road number.
Will you take the Carlisle Road? Shouldn't be more than 4 or 5 miles, sir.
Do we stay on this road?
Yeah, I'm afraid so. That's all there is.
Hey. What's that? The road.
It's not shown on the map. Should we take it?
We've no choice. Government property sign.
Maybe we struck a rival project.
There's been a lot of traffic here. Heavy stuff by the tire marks.
Traveling construction trucks.
There's another road. And more roadblocks.
Well, that's funny. To have a road leading to nowhere.
Hey, wait a minute. Don't walk on that stuff.
What?
It might be mined, anything. We'll go back and try the right fork. You game?
Sure. Oh, no.
project.
It's unbelievable.
We're wrong. We must be.
But those domes...
Coincidence of shapes must be an explanation.
But in so many details. What's all this debris? Do you think this could be the village that disappeared?
When it inflates? Whatever it was, it's been pretty well flattened.
Hey, look. Look on the ground. Look everywhere. They're all around us. Pieces of meteorite. And they're the same. They're exactly the same as the one we've got.
Some of these must have been here for months. They're crumbling.
Well, this one's quite recently broken.
Wonder if that's meant for us. Perhaps we'd better go and explain ourselves.
Hey, look at this, sir. Look at this. I think this is a whole one. Yes, it is. It's exactly the same odd shape as the other. It isn't even cracked. It's...
What is it?
That's funny. I thought I felt a sort of...
Put it down.
A sort of vibration.
Marsh, your face. There was something on your face. Are you all right? Let me take a look. You know, for a moment, I could have sworn I saw something that looked like a big black bubble. Marsh. You've got a lung full of gas. Try and stand up. Here, lean on me. Where can I find the police?
Police? Have you been in an accident or something?
Please, this is urgent. Where is the nearest police station?
Well, it's at Frawley, about 15 miles further on.
15 miles? You mean there aren't any police here?
Only the camp committee. They do everything around here.
Where can I find them?
Community center. First on the left, and then it's on the right.
Thank you.
Signed, etc., etc.
Tea and sandwiches.
Yes, please.
Is that the camp committee?
I'm the secretary. Can I help you?
They tell me you have no police here.
The police? Oh, do you know? We don't need them. We're a law-abiding community, aren't we, Miss Beale?
That's right, Mr. Dawson.
We handle any little problem.
All right, then tell me. What's that place just over the hill?
Over the hill?
That mill, that factory plant, whatever it is, just about 5 miles from here, with the big steel domes. What do they make there? What's its purpose?
There's another question you're asking?
They're perfectly simple questions.
Are they? Our people are working on this project, mister. They're construction workers building it and getting good money. In return, we're asked to keep our mouths shut, same as in wartime, see?
Now, listen, I just drove near that place.
Why, didn't you see the
My companion was suddenly affected by... Well, he was taken ill. Before I could get him out of there, the guards from that plant came and arrested him.
Guards? You got into trouble with the guards.
One of them took a swipe at me with his rifle.
Well, then you shouldn't have been there.
Listen, my friend's life may be in danger. He may need skilled help.
He'll get that in the plant.
Well, they've got everything there.
Well, let's make sure. Give me the police station at Frawley.
No, that won't do you no good.
We'll find out.
Go and talk to them if you like, but not from here.
The police couldn't do anything?
She's right. They wouldn't touch it.
Is that so?
The guards.
He shouldn't have gone. Hello? No, sorry. It was a mistake.
Unfortunate business.
The sergeant told you what happened.
He did. Your friend was arrested by security guards. If he was trespassing, I'm afraid they were in their rights.
Am I to understand that you flatly refused to do anything about this?
I don't know what you mean by flatly refuse, sir. As I see it, you ran into an experimental project you don't understand in a place you've no right to be.
What is that place?
I have no idea either, sir, except that it's top secret and we've strict orders about it.
From whom?
From Whitehall.
And you're telling me that nothing is to be done about what happened?
Well, what do you want me to do, sir? Are you bringing charges for assault?
Yes, if that'll get some action.
Very well, then I'll send in a report to the chief constable. And even he'll have to put it through London.
Forget it. I'll shortcut that.
Oh, Mr. Quatermass, how well called
Where's
you
Dr.
know?
Brand?
In the observatory, but there are several notes here I think you want
Tomorrow.
To look at.
Brand, there's been more traces about an hour ago. Few and faint, but in the same direction.
I want you to organize all the help you'll need. Fix a 24-hour guard.
What happened?
Do it now.
Kelly, locate Michaels and Peterson. Get them over here right away.
I think they look good.
They're in their quarters. This is urgent.
We found the place those things had been falling. The whole area is littered with fragments of them. They look like meteorites, but they're not.
Well, what are they?
They're some form of container. Marsh found a whole one. When he picked it up, it burst in his face.
What was inside?
Ammonia gas. And something else. Something alive. Just for a second, I saw it on his face. Then it was gone. But the mark was there. And the guards came, took him away.
Guards? What guards?
Sorry, I guess I'm not making
much sense. Where is this place?
It was Winnerton Flats. And there's something else there, Bran. The Moon Project.
The Moon Project? Now, wait.
There, at Winnerton Flats, the Moon Project, in all its essentials, a colony of steel pressure domes hundreds of feet high. I saw it. Marsh saw it.
Where is Marsh?
He's in that place. The guards took him there. And Mark, it was on their faces, too.
What did you do?
I worked for the police.
And?
Brand, the police won't act.
You told them all about this?
I told them all they were capable of believing. Tomorrow I'll go to London. Take it to top level.
We'll probably find there's some simple explanation we haven't even thought of.
I hope that's it. I hope it is, because if it isn't, I think we're on the verge of something so ugly.
Yes,
what is it? Peterson and Mr. Michaels are coming right in.
Oh, thanks, Kelly.
Do you want me to stay too?
No, thank you. Just organize some more coffee before you leave.
Of course.
It isn't credible. Brand, it just isn't credible.
Better handle it gently till the plaster hardens, sir.
How much of this is guesswork?
Hardly any, sir. It's worked out from mineral stresses.
Brand.
Coming.
Want a half dozen more of these models for wind tunnel tests. Have them made in the shop as soon as you can.
Yes, sir.
Original shape.
Aerodynamics.
If an object like that were to approach the Earth's atmosphere at the correct angle, it might lose speed in breaking ellipses and land relatively slowly. Same principle as rocket descent.
That implies a great deal.
Knowledge. Mathematics, precise planning. Intelligence.
Dr. Brandt.
There are more traces coming in. Right, I want to try something different. We have to adjust the radio telescope to a completely new setting for long range.
That means resetting half the circuits.
I'll work them out now.
This is an unexpected pleasure.
Well, Mac.
Have they found them?
No, not yet, Harry. So there's still time for good behavior.
All right, Sergeant, let him ruminate a bit longer. Off you go, Harry.
I could sue the police for wrongful arrest.
Very good idea. Sorry, sir, a bit of my homework. Well, sir, it has been a while since we met. Last time, you brought me more trouble than I've known before or since.
Inspector.
Sit down, sir. Make yourself comfortable. Have a cigarette.
No, thank you.
Funny, I was only saying to the wife the other day...
Inspector, just how much do you know about a place called Winnerdon Flats? What's going on there? What's its purpose?
I thought better of you, spoiling a beautiful friendship.
What do you mean?
You must know as well as I do that Winnerdon Flats is top secret.
Secret? You put a label like that on anything and Law and Order goes out the window, is that it?
Now, look here, sir. It's your little habit to ride roughshod over everything and
everybody. These are pieces of an object found near Winnerdon Flats.
When the stone broke up, suppose a bit of it hit Marsh. The mark on his face might have been a cut.
It wasn't.
All right, but... Well, that place should be harmless enough.
Then you do know what it is.
Yes, sir?
Green Park, 4394, Mr. Vincent Broadhead.
Who's he?
I only know him slightly, a member of Parliament. He's been trying to force a public inquiry about Winnerdon Flats. Maybe you should talk to him.
Will he tell me what the place is?
It's a government project to make synthetic food.
Synthetic food? With guards and guns?
They must think it worth guarding. Hello? Mr. Broadhead? Inspector Lomax, sir. I've someone here you might like to meet. He has some rather curious information about a certain establishment. Are you dependable, sir?
What?
Quite dependable. In an hour, at the House of Commons?
Yeah.
Yes, he'll be there. Quatermass. That's right. Not at all, sir. You realize, of course, that if anyone else had told me this yarn...
Broadhead.
Broadhead.
Thank you, Inspector.
All I ask, Mr. Broadhead, is to break through this wall of secrecy.
Me too, Quatermass. But let me tell you this. There's a reason for this secrecy. Winnerdon Flats is a blunder. The biggest blunder has been with public money. But they're trying to cover it up.
Even to the extent of armed guards arresting sick men.
Oh, that's a good point. I'll turn you, sir.
Do we know it's synthetic food? Do we know what they're doing down there?
Don't know anything. That's what I'm bellyaching about. Oh, yes. For years, we've known that a group of scientists has been working down at Winnerdon Flats. But that was just a couple of tin huts and a pinhole in the budget. But suddenly, bingo, they've got it. They're asking for millions and getting them, too.
When did all this start?
About 2 years ago. Now there's a mad rush to get a production plant built. Tremendous, insane costs. And now I gather they're ready to go into production and beat the world. But they've got to prove that to Vinnie Broadhead. Because I've found out there's something wrong, Quatermass. Something very wrong.
What?
Take a look out at the Thames. What do you see? Boats, barges, tugs. All that's missing. There's no distribution set up for this synthetic food. None. No sales organization. Nothing at all. Well, that's what I've found out.
Mr. Broadhead, whether you believe all the things I've told you or not, you've just got to help me get into that place.
Help you? For months I've been trying to help myself. The pass is only just coming through this morning. Minister Chap should be here by now.
You're going inside the plant?
Yeah, this afternoon. And don't think they won't be sorry to let me. They may fool the others, but not Vinnie Broadhead.
There have been others.
Oh, yes, parties going down to inspect it.
Were they people you knew?
Aye, some of them. You're thinking something happened to them. No, lad, they turned up again.
Did they say what they'd seen?
No, they wouldn't talk about it.
Isn't that strange in itself?
No, no, no. They had the wool pulled over their eyes, decided to be loyal, toe the party line, support the project. Just let me get at it.
Mr. Broadhead.
Are you Mr. Broadhead?
Ah, that's right. Oh, are you the chap with my pass?
For the inspection party this afternoon.
Fine, it only took 3 months. Oh, I was wondering whether I might bring somebody along. Yes, that's right, this gentleman here.
Ma'am? Wait a minute. Yes, I think that'll be in order. Just a minute, please.
Well, looks as though I should have brought you along 3 months ago.
The inspection party will assemble for transport at 2 p.m. in Parliament Square.
Fine, that just gives us time for a bite of lunch.
It doesn't always take 3 months.
Are you coming, Quatermass?
Yes. Thank you.
You've just over an hour. And do please try to be punctual. We have a very tight schedule ahead of us.
Easy, guards. They look harmless enough.
buses, please. Thank you. Nothing very sinister so far. There's nothing abnormal about them. I'm going to take a look in there. Do you want to come?
Just a minute. Have you seen the other two men?
The last time I saw them, they were back there.
Now, you wait here. I'll find them.
What do you want, please?
Oh, we're an inspection party.
You have no business here.
Well, it's official. They took our pass.
Have you any patients here?
There is no one.
We thought a young man was brought in here yesterday by the guard.
I think I'll take a look.
Any sign?
No, he was here. He must have been. Yesterday afternoon. His name was Marsh.
No.
Hey, what are all these beds for? You're evidently prepared for...
Gentlemen!
So why have you left the inspection party?
You mustn't do that. Come now, quickly. I just wanted to see...
There's no one.
Within...
Come, please.
I still
all
want to know...
questions will be answered later. Now will you come with the others, please?
Come on, Quatermass.
We want to see the plant, don't we?
You understand, gentlemen. We must keep strictly according to time.
But the plant...
You'll see it all. Everything. Gentlemen... I regret the delay.
Our fault. We took a look round.
It's all right. I haven't wasted time. Been reading up synthetic food processes.
Now, please, we start this way.
This wasn't much help. It's all completely different.
You'll be shown everything later.
What are those enormous domes?
They're for storage.
What of? Synthetic food?
That is correct. It matures in those domes. But please, everything will be answered later. Now, this way, if you will go first.
These pipes, what runs through them?
The food. Now, let's proceed.
The food, you mean the raw product?
The raw product.
And it's pumped through these pipes to the domes?
Everything will be answered later.
Look, that's an inspection door, isn't it? So you can see the stuff going through. I'd like to take a look at that.
Later, you will see everything.
Are we going to see inside a big dome?
That's where you're going now. Please continue. Mind a step. This way, please. Right along, will you? Quickly. Keep moving.
Oh, dear, it's your feet.
We're not inside the dome, are we?
No. This is an airlock. It's not possible to enter the dome itself, but you'll be taken downstairs.
What, down there?
It's quite safe.
Well, you'll have to go first. I have no head for height.
What's going on down there?
It's part of the process.
Please don't wait here. We must keep going.
Where's the other man?
The other man? Go ahead.
I didn't see him come in.
Now, please don't worry. He'll be found and everything will be in order.
It all looks most efficient. What are you doing? Sending a search party?
What's this?
A safety precaution. Shall we go down?
I don't want to.
I'm afraid we must.
In mobile. That's right. He's here, Inspector Baker. All right.
Hi, General.
Good evening, Mr. Hall.
Been any good charge sheets lately?
Oh, nothing that you want to print.
Trade you a drink for anything that'll fill 1.5 columns before midnight.
Well, how about reporter help for bribing the police?
Yeah. Who's the boss man tonight? Come out, whoever you are. Well, if it isn't Dolly Baker.
Hello, Jimmy.
There must be something. A little arson? Mayhem? Just a left skullduggery to fill 1.5 columns.
Sounds going straight tonight, Jimmy.
Then tell me the story of your life.
Yeah. What a gift. Yes, sir?
Is Chief Inspector Lomax still here?
Well, if you fill in the form, we'll find out for you, sir.
That won't be necessary. He's here, he'll see me. My name is Quatermass.
Wait a minute. Don't I know your name?
Possibly.
Couldn't be the old Bailey. You're not the criminal type. Jimmy Hall can tell him every time.
Okay, sir.
Constable will show you up, sir.
Thank you. I know the way.
Wait a minute. Why do I know that name?
Lomax, I'm glad you're here.
very nearly enough. Just called the wife to say...
How much power have you got here? How much real authority?
Afraid I don't quite understand.
Could you call an emergency action on a large scale? It'd have to be.
Action for what?
An action if I told you that what is really being carried out in Winterden Flats is the mass destruction of men's minds.
Now, look, sir, I'm a pretty ordinary sort of fellow with a pretty ordinary sort
of mind. Broadhead took me down there this afternoon with an official inspection party. The place is almost exactly what I told you it was. I got out of there alone. The rest of them got trapped in the staying. I was meant to be one of them.
Are you suggesting they've been murdered?
I'm suggesting that they have been methodically infected with the same thing that struck young Marsh yesterday.
You mean that mark?
Maybe the mark. I don't know yet. But I do know that they'll come back. Like hundreds, maybe thousands of others have come infected. If I'd have stayed there, I might be here talking to you now, but not saying the things I'm saying. I wouldn't be able to.
Does Vincent Broadhead think this?
Vincent Broadhead is dead.
Dead?
I watched him die a few hours ago in that plant. His whole body covered with some kind of corrosive poisoning, eaten away. Some of the black slime got on my coat. I had to cut out the spot. Don't touch it.
And how does that story measure up with this one?
This is a lie. Vincent Broadhead was with me this afternoon at Winterden Flats. Where did this story come from?
It says an official government announcement.
The minute they knew he was dead.
Are you seriously trying...
Broadhead was with me and the others at Winterden Flats, and he was killed by a corrosive compound of ammonia, which is what they're manufacturing in that plant.
Quatermass, do you realize what you're alleging? That in a government-sponsored...
The point is that I am still here to allege it. Take a squad of men into that plant. You'll get your proof soon enough.
You know I can't do that.
Then get your pathologist to analyze that and confirm it. You've got to start an investigation.
But on your statements alone?
You've got to. Talk to the commissioner. Let me talk to him. Lomax, you've got to act.
Yes, sir?
Is the commissioner gone?
Not yet, sir.
This better be true. That's all I have to say. It better be true.
I wish to heaven it wasn't. Get me Camford 647.
Yes? Inspector Lomax to see you, sir.
Come in, Lomax.
I'm sorry to bother you, sir. Something's come up that I'm not sure how to handle.
Sit down, tell me about it.
It's difficult to know where to begin, sir. The implications are so far-reaching, if there's anything in them, that it's a matter of top policy.
Yes?
Well, sir, it concerns...
It concerns...
Concerns the Ormond case, sir. The man we are holding. I thought if we turned him loose, he might lead us to something. I mean, give us a lead to accomplices, and I wondered if you had any views on the subject, sir.
Decision is yours, Lomax. You're conversant with the case?
Of course, sir. I'm sorry. I made a mistake worrying you at this hour.
All right.
Good night, sir.
Good night.
Scotland Yard.
Quatermass, I've been trying to find you all evening. We trace the source of these things. It's in a freak orbit on the dark side of the Earth, in a permanent state of eclipse. That's why it's not visible. It must be something like an asteroid, about 200 yards across.
Look, take full records till I get there. Yes, I'm trying to. They found the source of those things. I'm going back.
Quatermass, the mark you saw on Marsh and the other man. Describe it. Quick, tell me.
Well, it was a reddish mark, as if something had been pressed into the skin, and it left a jagged V.
How big?
About this big. Why?
I've just seen it.
Here? In this building? No. Even here?
I'm trying to tell myself there's nothing to it, that you're wrong.
I wasn't wrong last time, was I?
Hey, Daryl.
Jimmy, what do you want?
1.5 colors.
Not now, Jimmy.
Quatermass, the rocket man. Telephone hall number.
Will you leave us alone, please?
What's the matter? Somebody thinks he's wrong.
Jimmy, I wouldn't want to have you escorted out. Who's that?
Crime reporter, if he's harmless enough. Quatermass, if you could make it public, put it before the whole country, everything, all at once.
You mean the press?
It must be worth trying.
Jimmy! Well, Max, that man is in no condition.
The drunk Jimmy Hall is clever. Sober, he's brilliant.
I was going.
Listen, Jimmy, you came here for a story. Well, you're going to get one. The biggest you've ever had in your life.
At dictation speed.
You have a car?
Where are we going?
To your base.
Base? Yeah. Well, don't point.
See it there? That point of light at the intersection. That's radio waves being reflected by something out in space.
Is it coming towards us?
No, it's just circling on the dark side of the Earth.
And there's life on it?
Not life as we know it. They probably have their own artificial atmosphere. Ammonia, methane.
Poison gases.
It comes from a region where such conditions do exist as atmosphere. The outer planets. Maybe a moon of Saturn.
Can I have a scotch in this?
It's growing weaker.
I think it's a multiple organism, 1,000 billion intelligences, if you like, with one single consciousness.
Look, I'm a policeman.
Try and imagine an organism to which oxygen is not an essential of life, but a destroyer. An organism which is unable to exist in our atmosphere for more than 3 or 4 seconds, safe only in a shell, like this, sealed in with a mixture of gases, methane, maybe even hydrogen.
And when it breaks out?
It dies. Unless its energy is expended on an object that can exist in our atmosphere, a human target.
And what happens to the human target?
An immediate invasion of his entire nervous system. Something is implanted, an instinct, a blind compulsion to act for them.
You expect me to tell my editor that?
But, Hall, you must. There's no time to lose.
Don't rush me, General. Don't rush me. You've given me a lot of science talk, and I'm not very good at it. All I do understand is somebody swiped your moon project.
But it never was all mine. This would be fairly standard procedure for adapting living beings on an alien planet.
But, Quatermass, if you're right, what's going to happen? What's the ultimate object?
I hesitate to guess, Inspector. First, a few of these things came here, at random, scattered, and then expended themselves to a purpose. A year ago, phase number 2, the concentrated attack.
On one of them flats.
An out-of-the-way village with a little government research plant. One night that area was taken. Now they've got themselves a colony.
And all this went on for a year and nobody said anything?
But who knows how many infected people they've got in high places.
And what about here? Can you be sure of all your stuff?
I think so. I'll step up security in the morning. The next move is Hall's. We've got to break this conspiracy of silence and secret orders. You've got to write this man now. Look, get all this down. I'll check it with you. Then I'll drive you into London. We don't even dare use a telephone.
How far is this plant from here?
About 90 miles.
I want to see it.
But man, time is desperate.
These people at work, are they normal?
At the moment, I think so.
I want to talk to him.
Jimmy.
Relax, General. We'll still make the first additions. I'm lost among all this stuff. I want to talk to some numbskulls like myself.
All right, we'll go now.
Well, you too. Isn't that a risk?
The biggest risk is that this story won't get in at all. I'll see you outside in 15 minutes. There are certain arrangements I want to make, an alternative plan in case of emergency.
You need any help?
I don't think we should share that knowledge until you know where we're going. I'll see you outside. Brent, I want double security throughout the base. All gates, rocket firing, base bunkers, double guard on all points. And I want to talk to you in the control room.
Right.
Get me the laboratory. I'm making a list of people I know I can trust. Good. You keep it. We'll need every one of them.
Flats on the line.
Thank you. Mrs. Quatermass, what about that analysis?
Well, we're just finishing, sir. We've got about 5 cc's from that piece of cloth. It's the most complex substance. I've never quite met anything like it before. It's basically an ammoniac corrosive, highly concentrated.
Yes. Just how poisonous? You see? Right. The full report as soon as you can. Go see if the car is there.
It is, sir.
Go and see.
Yes, sir.
Well? That black slime is deadly to every living thing on Earth.
So it isn't synthetic food?
On the contrary, Lomax, I think it is. Food for whatever is in those domes. Domes 200 feet high. Secretary.
Two bears and a double.
What's working conditions like?
Near the plant? Well, it couldn't be better.
kill with their pain unskilled labor.
Chef.
Oh.
You want a job? Steve's shop is
good. Good evening. What seems to be the trouble?
No trouble.
Someone's asking about work at the plant.
Oh. Are you three together?
Yes.
And you're looking for heavy construction work. Well, even if you're right, we all work that are engaged with government contractors.
Give it to him straight, Mac. There's no jobs. Even we're on short time.
Hold
now.
The time, Pat. Who's kidding? Who? The plant's nearly finished. And when it hits below, we'll
nobody's dead, Dad.
I suppose the zombies aren't turning on our heels to get out.
Zombies?
It's a special nickname given to special forces.
Nicknamed disease looking out of parishes. We hate their guts, and don't anyone deny it.
Gone.
Now, take your truck.
Well, don't we? Treat us like dirt, never talking to us. Who do they think they are?
They run the plant?
Sure they do.
And they operate the dome?
No.
Oh. What's inside those domes, Penny?
Suddenly you know too much.
Yes, who are you?
I know him. He was here 2 days ago. Got into trouble with the guards.
Yeah, so we don't want no guard trouble here. Out with them.
Now, right, stop. Wait a minute. Listen to me.
It's useless, but you've got to try.
Quiet, everyone. Quiet, please. Quiet, everyone. Listen to me. This is vitally important to all of you. Please, may I have your attention?
What's it all about?
Who is he?
Who are you? I'm a police officer.
We don't have police here.
Well, you have now. Turn that music off. Now, the gentleman over there is a scientist, and I want you to listen to what he has to say. If what he says is right, you're in great danger, all of you.
Danger?
What danger?
Why are the police here?
It's about that place you've been working on, helping to build. He's been spying on the plant, and the man with him was arrested. Ask him. He told me himself, ask him.
You think that place is producing human food? It's not.
Food? What do you know about that?
He's been spying.
That plant is producing deadly poison. Poison to every earthly creature.
Who's making poison? What does he know?
Please. Let me explain. I can prove everything I'm saying.
You better, my boy. He's a liar. Out with it. We're making poison, he says.
Throw him out. No more.
You ask him.
We're not fighting him. Will
there
be trouble?
Now, get out before there's any more trouble.
Andy.
All right, keep back, everybody.
Take it out. Guys, all right. Now, keep back, please. Leave me alone.
Came through the roof. What was it? There, it is under the floorboard.
Keep back, man.
Who are you telling to keep back?
That may be dangerous.
Dangerous, my foot. It's an overshot, that's all.
Overshot.
How is she, Mac? Not hurt?
No, it was just right.
Oh, I'll be all right in a minute. Take a sit of this man. Oh, it's the first time one's fallen this far away.
You called it an overshot.
That's right. Scary things that fall outside the plant, usually at night.
What are they supposed to be?
Oh, something to do with the process. Don't ask me. Oh, look at the mess it's made in the floor.
Stay back, girl. It's a hole underneath the floorboard. We've got to get everyone out of here.
Well, now, come along. Everybody outside, please. Come along. I'm sorry to interrupt the festivities. Is she all right?
Yes,
but we'll try to take her outside. Now, come along, please. Quickly. Outside.
Please. You must clear this hall. It's ready. Come along. Where you go?
What's all the fuss about? It's an overshot.
Do you think it was a bomb?
Look, no matter what they've told you about these things, they're not harmless. Now, along you go. Out you go, please.
Wait a minute.
Here it is. It's still warm.
Put it down as slowly as you can.
Oh, it's only an overshot. Like Patty said.
On the floor. Put it on the floor. Gently.
Sheena! Look on that. Sheena! What is it? Sheena!
Can't we do anything?
Too late. You say you know what about this. All right, do something.
There's nothing to do now. You might call a doctor. Lomax.
Get a blanket.
The fact that thing landed so far from the plant might indicate that... Come on, quick.
Come on, Andy, quickly. See her. That thing on her neck. You all seen it, didn't you? It
came out of the stone.
The fella said it was dangerous.
Listen.
It's a sort of whistling.
I was right. They're coming down to the hundreds. Get Hall.
This is urgent. Priority.
Jimmy, quick, outside.
Be within a minute. I'm not holding this. News desk, quick.
It's a mass dropping, all right. Where's Hall?
He's running his story.
Not from here. I told him not to use the phone here.
Quatermass, look.
These things are coming in large numbers from outside the earth. Look, just take the story with you.
What did this? You know what did it. Tell us and try to save her. Do you hear what I say? Steady, buddy, steady.
Are you there? These things arrive in stone containers. A form of meteorite. They've been coming for the past 18 months.
The fool. Why does he come out?
If he lies low, he's got a chance.
Contact with these things produces a violent infection. Sort of sting.
I've just seen it happen. Stay on the line. I think I've been spotted. Get this quickly. This infection is widespread. What can you do now?
Where to? London?
No, the plane. Up and down there. Lomax. Look at this. Steel containers filled with their own atmosphere, gas supply. They must put them in here so they can get them back to the plant alive.
Well, don't touch it.
You take the car and go back to London.
Go back
and
speak to
the guys you can trust. Contact them, every one of them. Make them listen before it's too late.
If you ask me, we should both go back.
I've got to get into that plant. I may be able to do something.
Now, wait a minute.
It's up to you now, Lomax. You better hurry.
Don't struggle. Keep together.
How do we know they took her this way?
They'll move her to the medical center.
That's where they'll be, at the plant.
Poor kid. They knew what it was and they wouldn't see. That stranger, what had he done to get his face all shot up like that?
Filthy murdering swine. They're going to get it tonight.
Look out. Lights ahead. The car.
Quiet, boys. Hold your ground. Right across the road. Let me through. Stand clear.
It's the cop.
What's this about?
We're going to the plant.
Well, get back to your homes. You can't do anything. You only run into trouble.
We're after the men who killed your pal.
And they've taken young Sheila. Go back to your homes. You'll do more good if you go back.
We could use the car. Turn it round.
Look, don't stop.
Turn it round,
boys. I'm on my way for help. Go back home.
Emergency! Emergency!
construction workers, estimated 150 in number.
In a trap, I'd rather be outside. You must let me out.
Come here, do something. One grenade through that window will be blown to pieces.
Hey, no, the tank is here for the sake of the pressure control.
Pressure control?
This is the pressure control center. I helped build this.
You mean they feed those domes from here?
Each dome is controlled by a separate section.
Ammonia, methane, hydrogen, oxygen. It could be that they're being acclimatized. Lomax, you, give me a hand on these controls. This will be a long shot, but we've got to take it. Now, both of you, watch me. Do the same with those panels. Cut off the gas supply completely. Set them at zero. Like this. That should bring the oxygen up to full pressure.
Now, what's this going to do?
Choke what's in those domes, I hope.
You've seen?
I've seen.
What was it? I'm moving in.
Attention. Attention. Unauthorized personnel now in the pressure control block. Resistance by you must cease. Lay down your weapons and leave the building. You will be permitted to go to your homes pending further action. Leave the building at once.
They're still there.
Abandon weapons and come out.
Come out and be shot to bits, is that it?
I think we ought to know what they say.
We're holding this block. We've got to. At least until the oxygen takes effect.
What's in those domes, mister?
Resistance must cease immediately. Lay down your
weapons. Yes, where is it? Tell us. Inside those domes are creatures from outside this earth.
Are you mad?
I've seen them. Thousands of tiny creatures that can join together and expand into things 100 feet high. And each one can infect a human being.
Like you did, Sheila.
Yes, and those wretched creatures you call zombies. Take a look at them. You'll find the mark.
Unauthorized personnel in pressure control block. You will not be harmed. Leave the building at once, or other means of forcing your surrender will be used.
How long before that oxygen takes effect? How can I tell? Maybe hours.
And what then? Will the others coming?
There will be, unless we can destroy the asteroid, the thing they're coming from. How are you doing?
Your emergency plan. What was it?
To use the rocket as a guided atomic bomb.
And when was that to happen?
I told Brand that if he didn't hear from me to set it off by midnight.
But you're not seriously going to launch that bomb?
This is it, Peterson. Control room. Michaels, Brand, check rocket motor set to critical phase. We're launching. Don't argue, do it. Attention, everyone. Brand to all sections. Clear base for firing. Repeat. Clear base for firing. Immediate.
We know it'll even take off without blowing up.
We don't. Check. Fuel on.
Compression. Marsh. Jesus.
Don't touch him. Don't touch anything. Come.
Crowbar with a cup. Never ready for anything.
Only tank guns.
We'll need more than any tank guns to get us out of this.
Somebody's shooting off flares.
Flares?
Right across the sky. Where?
Where?
Well, it's gone now. No, there it is. Is it a flare?
No. It's not a flare.
What is it?
It's the one thing that may save us and humanity.
Too cursed quiet for my liking. What are they up to?
Yes. What was the other means?
Probably just a war of nerves.
Any reaction yet?
I've done all I can. Pure oxygen. It must be taking effect by now. It must.
Quatermass. What happens if we fire an anti-tank smack into the domes?
Whatever came out would be completely beyond our control. No, this is the best way. Poison them slowly. If we can.
If you can't. That's a lot of ifs, mister. How long are we going to trust your guesses?
All this gaff about a rocket and things.
What's the proof you know what you're talking about?
You must believe me. We're all that stands between these things taking possession of perhaps the whole world, spreading over it and infecting every human being.
And who's seen these mysterious things but you?
Attention, attention. Switch off. Sabotage must cease. Switch off. Cut. Oxygen now being passed into the domes
will destroy
the process you have helped to create. The management are still anxious to cooperate. Anyone injured in recent violence will receive treatment. Go now. Hurry.
Okay.
Hurry.
Me too.
There we are. It's a trick. Maybe it is, but whose trick? You saw your friends murdered out there?
We started a riot, didn't we? On his word. And if we were wrong...
He knew that's what was in those domes. What proof has he given us?
This is the last appeal to you as reasonable men.
Hello. Hello. My name's McLeod. I'm speaking to the pressure control block. Put me through.
Who's speaking?
E.G. McLeod, Judge Handwelder. We want to know what's inside those domes. There's a fellow here says there's living things in them.
McLeod, don't be a fool.
Leave me alone. I must speak to him.
Let him speak. There is nothing alive in the domes.
They're lying.
The entire plant is open to inspection. Whatever you may wish to see will be shown.
Don't listen to them.
Help me, buddy. Leave him.
McLeod, dear, I'm accepting your offer. I want to see inside one of the domes.
Don't do it, McLeod.
Come alone or bring your comrades for time. Meet us 2 minutes from now outside Dome 3.
Right. Dawson, you coming?
Yes. Open the door. Honey, you stay guard here.
You'll all be infected. All right, everyone, relax. Ernie, keep them covered in case.
The men aren't in uniform.
No guns, any of them.
Maybe they mean it. They'll be infected. That must be the purpose of this.
That's what I'm afraid of.
And they'll put one of them on the speaker.
Now listen, he's right. Any moment now, McLeod or one of the others will talk to you over that and tell you everything is all right, but I beg of you, don't believe him.
What's that? He's carrying along one of the pipes. That was screams. If they come back on their word.
Quiet.
What's that?
Attention! Switch off!
Not here! What?
Emergency!
Get
dressed. You better be ready for anything.
It's here in the room. Look, the pipe, it's burst.
All right, only active.
What's happened?
Dome 3. Look at that pressure.
No wonder it blew.
That pipe must be blocked at the other end.
Blocked with what? Blocked with what, mister? There's something dripping. It's blood.
Your blood?
It's them. McCartney and Dawson. It must be.
The thing's turned on him. They used them to stop the flow of oxygen. That pipe has been blocked with human pulp.
No. He's a filthy, murdering swine.
Now.
I got it. The whole dome. Hey, get on it, brother.
Must be wearing off, leaving them, perhaps all of them.
What's happened? Where is this?
You'll be all right now, sir.
Lean on me, mate. You'll be all right.
You know what worries me? How am I going to make a final report about all this?
What worries me is how final can it be?
Hey!
Thank you.